started as an outbreak in China near the end of 2019 has quickly developed into a global epidemic. Now, last week, for the first time since the outbreak began, the number of new cases outside of China was greater than inside the country. And while the Philippines has long kept the virus at bay, it seems we weren't really spared, just left behind the curve. Now, to help us solve the economic puzzle that is COVID-19 and how the country can fight back, Congressman Joy Salceda now joins us live in our Rockwell studio. Congressman Joy, thank you so much for joining us.
Yes, thank you. Good morning.
Okay, so let's start with COVID-19. What measures, what relief measures is Congress preparing to help private companies cope with this virus? Because last Friday, did you see the photos of Green Hills? They were like ghost town.
Ang focus natin is to save that one life that could still be saved. Because apparently the virus is preventable. Although we are very porous and we have too many susceptibilities to it. Ang unay namin talaga yung pag-approve po ng 2.1 billion na in-request po ng DOH for supplemental budget. I think we can do it this week.
Is 2.1 billion enough?
No, no. Siguro ang mas importante na kasi otherwise uubusin muna natin yung contingency fund ng presidente. Pero yung final ko kasing bill tungkol sa CDC, very clear po doon na pwedeng gamitin ang calamity fund. Kasi ngayon, yung declaration ng public health emergency, hindi po talaga clear, sinasabi lang na to enable LGUs and other government instrumentalities to mobilize resources. Pero pag binasa mo talaga ano yung mga powers because you call it an emergency, therefore, pero dapat i-clear talaga doon na it should be ang tinitingnan ko is Taiwan proposal so dapat unang-una magamit yung pondo
ng CDC.
Kaso wala nga tayong
wala
CDC.
Pang CDC.
So yung DOH in particular. So pag may health emergency, dapat yung procurement, yung usual po na DDR, yung disaster, disaster emergency, once you declare a state of calamity, dapat meron siyang ano.
So sir, how much money does the DOH have now to fight COVID-19?
Actually, I would say that they are asking money already.
Oh, so no more money to fight it.
Kasi
so
yung sa Epidemiology Bureau nga, binaba nila from 254 to 115.
Okay.
So just to show you na we are, well, nasa dulo tayo ng curve, so I don't know whether we have done enough talaga.
So 2.1 billion?
Yeah. Initially.
Initially.
Opo. Pero yung pag nag-declare ng state of calamity sana, then pwedeng gamitin po yung lahat ng calamity funds. And there are about, at this time, about 32 billion there. At 20 billion sa national government. Tapos po sa mga local governments, you have 5% of 600. There are about 32 billion.
All in all.
All in all.
What about for businesses, Congressman? Because China started to give out cash incentives already to businesses
kasama
affected, given
sa
that they meet requirements like keep their labor force at least 80% working.
Actually, kasama po yan sa mga dun sa proposed DDR na pwede magbigay po ng interest rate loans ng ang ating pong mga not government financial institution, but rather pwede magkano yung ating pong gobyerno.
DDR would stand for
Department of Disaster Resilience. Yung proposal po to. Pero yung existing one, which is RA10121, ando na po yan. Mm-hmm. Yung pwede magbigay ng tax breaks ang BIR.
Mm-hmm. Who decides if BIR gives
I think,
tax
of course, DOF. But of course, that can be usually sa kabinete yan mangyayari. Kaso yung problema nilalaban natin itong COVID-19 with a task force. So kailangan there has to be an institution. Yun nga sana CDC kasi the CDC is governed by a Health Emergency Coordinating Council. Mm-hmm. So siya talaga nandun po, it's headed by the DOH, pero nandun po lahat ang mga kailangan niyang supporting ng departments.
Mm-hmm. But since there is no CDC yet, we just have a
DOH that essentially has to go to the cabinet as task force.
Mahaba.
Hindi naman mahaba, kundi of course, kaya nga wala, parang walang mukha. Have you seen a picture of the IATF meeting on the management of emerging and re-emerging diseases? Wala nga eh. Baka mga USAC lang ang nandun.
So the
fighter should have a face.
Mm-hmm.
Especially that ang kalaban mo is faceless.
Mm-hmm. And sir, so right now there's no CDC yet. What can Congress give to the public aside from approving this DOH additional budget?
Definitely talaga yung para sa mga economic measures. Ang pinakamagandang magawa dito is si TIRA. Kasi that's equal to 1.2% of GDP.
But that's going to be long term. For the future use na yan.
Yung dun sa mga affected firms, definitely we can come up with a comprehensive assistance to businesses affected by ano. And kaso, bakit yung businesses ang unahin? Unahin mo yung mga workers.
Yung mga workers.
Opo.
So what can the workers expect?
Mayroon tayong tupad, and mm-hmm. we have the test tulong sa hanap buhay. Actually, para sa mga OFW na natanggal yun noon eh. Pero ngayon, nandiyan pa rin siya as a policy instrument. So
pwedeng doon sila ipasok.
Oo, tapos pwede natin i-activate po yung unemployment insurance po mm-hmm. na under SSS.
Mm-hmm.
Gives you 2 months relief.
Requirement na to, sir?
I think yun ang dapat mabuo na sa mga displaced workers. Ibig sabihin, katulad na limbawa dyan sa BGC, wala ng Shoppers o sa
Green Hills.
Sa Green Hills. What baka pati kailangan eh, kasi lahat ng sakit nandito sa Metro Manila eh.
So what do you suggest?
I don't know. Baka kailangan saran mo muna NLEX, SLEX.
Serious?
No, I mean, I'm just saying, we might, kung talagang lumalapo, kung magkaroon po ng community transmission dito, I think, NCR is where all the virus is eh. So, you have to keep...
You propose we lock down NCR for now?
Definitely, it should not be off the book. A lockdown of NCR should not be off the book.
For how long?
Generally, I think until you reduce the code red back to number 3.
Will you be filing anything to push?
No, that's already in there. They have enough powers under mm-hmm. the emergency powers of the president. Okay.
Do you subscribe to estimates, sir, that with the COVID-19, 1 percentage point can be shaved off our GDP?
Ako 0.5.
That's what Neda
ako
said.
0.5 to 1.5.
Malaki.
Ah, yeah.
You have
yeah.
a much bigger.
Kasi nagsimula ako sa ano ba yung length niya? MERS-CoV 2 months, SARS-9, H1N1 14. So assuming ako 8.4 months. So, sa tourism pa lang, yung first 3 months, 43 billion na.
Aha.
Meron pa po yan spillover. Tapos, so, ang tingin ko dyan, mga... Iwan ako to sa'yo.
Yes. Sir, but generally...
Ito, so, roughly mga 218.5 billion.
Okay.
So,
in pesos.
So, 0.4 to 1.5% of GDP.
For the year.
For the full year yan. So,
do you think
tapos ang pero yung jobs ko is 92,000 to 175,000 jobs.
Okay.
So, hindi yan ganun kalala sa sinabi nung ADB. Ang problema lang kasi yung tinatamaan yung mga sector na magaling mag-produce ng jobs. Because in these industries that are being affected, service sector,
yeah.
tourism sector, they're pretty horizontal industries.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Very horizontal. So, basta may demand, automatic may
job.
Do
you think this is the beginning of the end of China's reign as the world's
factor? Hindi. Magre-rebound dyan. Yung nandun pa rin naman yung mga structural elements.
But everyone's starting to rethink. To move their factories.
They always do that. I mean, in terms of diversification, mm-hmm. at the end of the day, mas magagaling they're the most willful economic manager in the world. Okay. So by sheer willfulness, na I'm sure na they will come up with new packages, economic stimulus packages that will essentially ano. Mm-hmm. Pero dito nga sa atin, sabi ko, ano ba yung gagawin ko? Alaga mo ka. Unang-una, prevent it from being a disaster. I mean, this economic, this health emergency. So we should consider, for example, 1 week. Walang klase sa buong mundo, buong, kasi di, yung Pilipinas, kasi hindi mo alam kung nasaan yung virus, eh, di ba? So, kailangan ihiwa-hiwa. The rule there is social distancing. Mm-hmm. That's the basic principle. So, saan ba yung mga, saan ba yung grabing congregation, very persistent, araw-araw, walong schools. Oras. Yeah, of course, the schools.
Pati work suspension din ba, Congressman?
I think for NCR, yes.
And 1 week.
I mean, when I say when I talk about an NCR lockdown, I'm talking about NCR.
Everything.
Work stoppage for a minute. Oh, ano muna? Para maklik. Kung gusto mo talaga masolve to, kailangan you need talaga. Ang problema, it worsens the economic impacts.
Yun lang.
Yun lang. Kaya ayoko yung di kumbaga, I haven't made the pronouncement suggesting an NCR lockdown or an NCR
work. But it shouldn't be off the books.
Well, nationally, first on the book should be suspension of classes.
Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao.
Yes, kasi you don't know. Kasi these are, yung mga bata, di nga namamatay, pero transmission sila. Di ba? Mm-hmm. Hindi mo alam kung nasan yung transmission eh. Okay.
Congressman, we don't have much time. Let's move on to the next topic. Related to China pa din, POGOs.
Oh.
Because you sponsored the House Bill 5777.
Yes, to tax them.
You just give you the number. You called them exported hueteng before. So you want to tax them now, properly.
Yes.
In the last 4 years, sir, we made about 15, 16 billion pesos
actually,
from
for,
POGOs.
Yes, but
you're saying,
yung 2018-2019, ang nakita namin, kumita tayo ng 22.4 billion.
Oh, for 2 years?
Yes.
Okay.
So,
but you're saying we can actually make 24 billion pesos
we can make
per year.
More, we can make almost 56 billion per year by taxing them properly. 5%.
Ah, including the 5% franchise tax.
Ito yung amin. Pero yung okay. Para dyan makita natin.
This is 56 billion pesos.
Yes. Pero okay. Yung taxes nila has increased by 70%. Mm-hmm. If you include, kasi ang naka-record lang ng ano is 9 billion. Mm-hmm. POGO taxes collected, 6.42, ito.
Okay, we can show this.
So actually, the taxes that we got from POGO is okay. Up by 69%. I don't know where you will get that.
Wow, okay.
So this includes VAT from rent, because of their rent, we estimated everything.
So when they lease whole floors,
yes,
condominium units?
We looked at the leachu numbers, VAT from workers' consumption, mm-hmm. Excise tax on workers' consumption.
Okay.
So we're using a consumption year where 108,000 workers,
okay,
of which Filipinos are 21,000.
Maliit lang, Pinoy.
Yung apat na kumpanyang lumayas, wala pa 10,000. Kung ano-ano na sinasabi natin, ito 21,000. Mm-hmm. I really will support the president's position here. Keep them, but tax them.
Tax them. The bill that you sponsored, you tax them 5% franchise tax.
And a presumptive on the wages.
Okay.
500,000 per
year. The workers will be taxed 25%.
Yes, withheld.
Withheld now. But you submitted this, and the DOF actually had commentaries, they had recommendations.
Kasi nung that
they
was,
want a flat rate of 15% for the workers.
Binaba nila, pero dun sa committee, kinonsider namin yan, ang decision 25 pa rin. Kasi yan,
why are they saying flat rate? Is the 25% not flat?
Flat din. Flat rate din, 25. 20, pero hindi 15. Sir, ayaw ko bakit binabaan nila. Mayroon isang provision kasi na kung saan yung foreign professionals yata.
Yes.
Kasi baka pagbalik nila sa China, di ba, meron tayong mga tax treaty. So, kung mas mataas tayo, so 25, 15 lang dapat ang bayaran doon, yung workers, kawawa.
Congressman, you make a distinction between resident alien workers and non-resident alien workers. What is the difference?
Ang ibig sabihin ng Hindi ko alam na ano to, rivalida. Hindi kasi ako abogado eh. So essentially dapat yung taxation kasi ng dalawa pwedeng hindi o parehas.
So and pag, the resident ones are the ones who live here.
Yes.
The non-resident.
They are resident here eh.
Ah, and the non-resident.
Basically,
how do we tax them kung nandun sila?
Well, yung sinasabi nga namin na yung mga non-resident alien na labor force, obviously, ito yung, kasi dito, alam natin na there are, ito, 112,000, so it proves the locus of the earnings.
Aha.
Ito, 108,000. Mm-hmm. Kasi kung sabi ng OSG na yung situs ng earnings is offshore and therefore hindi natin matax. Kaya ito, sinasabi namin, ito resident alien.
And dito, nandito sila.
Yeah, it's siya si resident alien. Kaya gusto namin i-wish yan. At saka yung ang basis namin, ang legal basis, in real and real fundamental basis or empirical basis, why POGO should be taxed the way they should be taxed. Like 5%. License fee rather than a franchise tax. Mm-hmm. So there's no franchise. There's
and you want this placed under PAGCOR. Was it DOF who wanted this placed under PAGCOR's mandate? Hindi ba yun naman ang case na
yun? Yun naman ang case ngayon. Pero PAGCOR ngayon, collector lang. Pero i-remit nila sa BIR.
Ah.
So, pag tinignan mo naman, yung ano natin, sa estimated consumption ng POGOS, sa workers' consumption, mga 30 billion, it increased by 42% this year, 2019, last year. Sa rent naman, it increased by 13%. So, the total contribution of POGO to the economy was at 94 billion.
94 billion. And, for the last how many years?
Two years.
Final question, sir. We've covered the Senate hearings on the Pastilla scheme.
Opo.
Lots of crimes linked to POGOs. Cash smuggling, sex trafficking, and some are saying the social ills outweigh the economic benefits.
Actually,
what do you say to that?
Nung panahon na pagpasok ng mga Koreano, yun din ang naririnig mo eh. Mm-hmm. Nagkaroon tayo ng mga Korean village dito sa likod mo, ay sa harap mo dito. Oh, di ba? There are kidnappings, they gamble a lot kasi most of them come to gamble here eh, actually, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Kasi sa kanila hindi pwede mag-gamble.
Okay.
So, kaya nga para ma-solve natin 'yun kasi may mga regulatory or policy gaps tayo na kailangan pong punuan para po mas lalo nating makuha yung positive side nitong mga elementong to, which means the POGOs here. So, actually, we are now proposing an act penalizing bulk cash smuggling into or out of the Philippines. This is the measure of the committee.
Okay.
Yung five-man committee po ng Kongreso, kasama po si Suan Singh, si Garin.
We'll have to invite you again for another discussion on this. Thank you very much, Congressman, for joining us this morning. Salamat, sir.